And we're on here at the GSTL. I'm Tesis with Musertosis, and this is Epix versus Xenix. Epix.
Hey, everybody.
How you doing, dude?
Let me do the intro. Right,
yeah, you do it.
And we're off. It is FXO against Xenix. I am Artosis. He is Tasis. We are Tasis, the casting archon.
That was good. You're good at this.
Thank you.
I'll lose my job here, man.
I'm just going to replace
you. Taking over, dude.
I just have to talk in two voices to become a crazy person.
Yeah. All right. Here comes the team. FX Open.
And we have a lot of great players on this team. And every one of them just so well. There's Josh in the middle there. He is the owner of FXO.
And, of course, our commentator, Wolf, over there on the left. This is a big day for these guys. Actually, a big day here for us at the GSL, as we actually have international teams down here.
Yeah. This is really exciting. You know, FXO is playing in the first 5 weeks of this team week.
Yeah.
We'll be playing each and every week.
Oh, and look at this lucky fan. Going to get the flag.
Yeah. FXO Oz over there, I do believe.
That is.
Good StarCraft 1 pro game. Switched over to StarCraft 2. Was in FOU for a little bit, but now in FXO.
And look at this lucky fan that is clearly going to be put above her bed. Wake up every morning and see. Life is good, Artosis. Yeah. Look at all our nerds down there. There's Slog in the middle. We know him very well.
Oh, yes.
We've been playing tournaments against him back. Man, like five,
in
six,
StarCraft
7 years
1,
ago.
I played with Slog, Luna, and Shadow.
Yeah. So let's go a little bit more in depth with FX Open. This team, very, very good. It is, as you can see here, the first foreign team to participate in the GSTL.
Quite true. See a couple coaches there. Josh Jens-Rose and Daniel.
That's a...
Is that
actually like a zero?
It's like actually a number?
That's actually pretty badass. I need to get a number in my name.
Captain, of course, is Chef Sean Simon.
And Chef actually had dinner with him last night.
Oh, look at that QXC pose. He's like, come here.
Look at Andy, dude.
Oh, my God. He has the K-pop girl.
That is, yes.
Awesome. Awesome. Wolf been shrunken down in this picture so that Oz's head is about twice as big as his, even though he's the tallest person on the team, I think. Well, no, I guess he's too big.
This is a lot of fun, man. These guys all very nice guys. I was talking to QXC when I first got in here. He's excited, feeling pretty confident going into this. And I actually have to say this is a pretty well-balanced lineup they got here.
Yeah,
I don't think it's one of the teams
lineup
where it's more like, you know, you see some of these teams where it's like one or two heavyweights and the rest of the guys are like assassins. Dude, that picture of Slog is just hilarious.
Yeah.
I can't get over that. That's a brave man to do that.
Here's our team captain there, Chef.
Your Chef.
Best player on
known
FXO,
StarCraft 1 has chosen.
Yeah. Great player. I play with him all the time.
Really good. And you know what? Actually, what's funny for me, I was talking to him about this. Like I said, we got dinner last night. Took him out. Chef never played. I never played him back when he showed him. We somehow never had a face each other.
After Tasis was already in Korea.
I moved to Korea, but I never had, you know, everybody else in the States had the opportunity to play it against. There's Wolf. I also took him out.
Yeah.
Double man beat. Uh-huh. One nerd man is not enough. Tasis. Now, here are their opponents. Obviously, this is a pure Korean team here.
Xenix. Very good team. They're getting better and better. They were one of the weakest teams for a very long time, but they have some new up-and-coming stars such as Line. He's my favorite player on the team. Of course, Byun, my old nemesis, is on this team as well.
No, this is a great team. And they're steadily improving like a lot of these other teams. Not as quickly as a team like Prime. Uh-oh, some lucky nerd. Gonna get a Xenix.
Yeah, almost touching head to head.
Yeah, man. Traditional Xenix headbutt. Artosis, this is a big day down here with FXO facing off against the guys. The Koreans, of course, have a lot of pride. You know, they don't want to lose to a foreign team. Korea, you know, there's a few things that Korea's known for being the best in the world at. Archery is one.
That's true.
And another one is StarCraft.
There's a few.
Yeah.
They won women's weightlifting.
Did they?
I believe so, yes.
We're one of the best ice skating countries.
They are indeed.
But yeah, StarCraft is one of the things. StarCraft, you know, if you guys are just from StarCraft 2, never followed StarCraft 1. StarCraft 1 was very competitive, even internationally, even when there weren't a lot of tournaments.
Yeah.
Internationally. people like Artosis and myself were grinding year-round. Playing with Koreans and non-Koreans. But the Koreans were always, overall, just a little bit ahead of the non-Koreans. The only time we ever got to see the non-Koreans and Koreans compete was things like WCG, but of course that was the three best Koreans at the time. So,
yeah.
Kind of a lopsided lineup matchup there.
Now we see the captain, Zenix Puzzle. He's actually the guy that eliminated Chef from Code 8 today. Captain versus captain. Zenix won out in that one, 2-0. But we will see. Will the Zenix team be able to play at that same level? Zenix, again, has gotten a lot better. They were known really for Kyrix and Byun before. Now it seems like Puzzle and Line are the new Chogosers on this team.
There's an interesting obstacle here with FX Open in the sense that Zenix players aren't as well known. They aren't as televised.
Yeah.
So it's hard to know. How exactly are we going to pick which player to, to come up when we get to kind of the assassin phase of the tournament where, okay, there's just one guy here. Who are we going to send out? And look at Zenix Byun. He looks like he's about to start a sprint.
Yeah, he does.
Nobody fire any guns. He might run right through your screen.
Zenix Puzzle. Looks like he's checking how hot the pie is. No pie, though.
No pie. These guys all very good. Although, again, as many of you probably noticed who are watching, probably haven't seen most of these guys or seen much of most of these guys.
Yeah, June has been around a little bit. Puzzle a little bit. Byun a lot of it. And Soshin a long time ago, if anyone remembers him.
And the Zenix team has a lot of respect for FX Open. And here's a little prompt for FX Open. There is a lot of information about their players out there.
Yeah, if you know where to look, absolutely.
If you know where to look.
And these guys have played in a lot of tournaments.
So it's kind of a weird situation. Obviously, the Koreans, known for being the best in the world in StarCraft.
Yeah.
FX Open wants to win this, but, it's much easier because the international tournaments are quite open to the public for these guys to dig up information about this.
Yep. And we see here the two team coaches, basically, facing off. Looking sharp in that tie.
Looks good.
He does look good.
Handsome guy.
Yeah. Right. Cleans up very well.
Yeah. And now we're going to do this. It's getting close. Who do you think they're going to pick first for FX?
FXO? It's hard to say.
Why do I keep calling him FX?
Because the O is a different color.
Yeah.
That's why.
Well, I think I had this catchy idea in my head that it was going to be like FX against Zenix. No, it's FXO.
FX of X?
Artosis, what you doing, man?
No, wait, functions, hold on. Man.
There's only so much time, man. Who is going to go out for FX? Can I go first?
Go ahead.
I'm guessing QXC.
QXC?
That's who I'd send out.
Huh. I don't know if I would QXC. I think that I would use just kind of a broad-based player, someone that's good in all matchups.
Chef?
No, definitely not Chef. I would use Chef later on as a snipe. I don't know. I like to start off a team league with someone just, hey, he can probably take games off of anybody.
Who?
I want to
like
say
actually
T-Gun.
Not giving him the player,
I'll go with T-Gun. I would if
T-Gun?
If I was sitting up there right now and someone asked me, I'd put T-Gun out there.
T-Gun's actually not a bad choice either. I'm still going to go with my bet of QXC.
QXC?
That's just what I think is going to happen. We'll see, though.
Right. Well, the map is dual site, so QXC wouldn't be a bad choice.
Who do you think Zenix is going to put out there?
That's a harder one.
I would put Byun, but I feel like it's actually going to be somebody we haven't seen play before. Somebody like Kareem or something
I feel
that.
Like you're right that yeah. I think Byun would be a great choice because he's just very solid. Very solid overall. If he can take one or two games, then Zenix gets way ahead, and it's going to be very hard for FXO to catch up from there.
We'll see.
We'll see in a moment.
It's tough. Unless you have a team you're playing against that's basically very lopsided with, what races they're strong with, you tend to want to put a strong player out there who's well-rounded and has a lot of stamina.
Yeah.
Unless someone
that's bad under pressure, you want to use them in one of the first two games.
I think if there's somebody who's bad under pressure, you always want to use them in game number two.
But that's a good game.
Assuming that, I should say player number two, not game number two. Player number two. So that way, let's say that one guy wins a few games and then he gets knocked out.
But like if he loses, that's a little bit pressure-filled too.
Yeah. Well, I think it's going to be one of these things where if he's good in practice but not normally good in matches, then that's going to be player number two.
That's the way I feel.
You can't take that away from me.
I can take whatever I want from you.
No, you can't, Artosis. Don't you talk to me like
I'm
that.
I'm in control of you.
This is the GSL. We're based in Seoul, Korea. And I got to say, I love casting these Team League games, man.
Yeah, Team League is an amazing event.
It really is.
So happy we get to do 2 days of this right in a row. After coming back from vacation, so happy to be back, guys.
Yeah.
Thank you for waiting. Some of you less patiently than others.
We got plenty of tweets. Twitter. Like, yeah.
Get
Where
away.
Are you? I'm like, I'm a human being. I get a vacation like everybody else.
Yes.
By the way, feel free to add us on Twitter. Call me Tasteless. He is Artosis. And add Gom TV's Twitter, Gom TV. The old one is Gom TV Net. The new one is now Gom TV. Also, check out the new mobile feature at the GSL.
Yeah, that's very nice. You can watch it on your cell phone or something.
Yeah.
You know, watch on your iPad, whatever.
I'd watch it on my iPad.
I know you would.
I got an iPad.
I know you do.
There's all these like Apple haters like, no! Like shaking
their
face.
Nice.
It's a good piece of equipment. You know? Not saying Apple's good for everything. It's not. What did like Steve Jobs like say in that speech you were joking me about? Like, people that use PCs.
Said something to the effect of like, PC users live in the world. Apple users change the world. It was like the
most
corny, ridiculous.
It makes no sense. It's like most people that use Apple like don't know how to turn on a computer and stuff. All right. Here's our first player. Wow, Moonen. I did not expect Moonen to be picked first. This guy's very young. And I think, he's got a lot of potential, but you put somebody young out there, sometimes they get a little bit more nervous.
Yeah, he's a very good player, though. I used to play with him in StarCraft 1 quite a bit. He was an up-and-coming Terran in that game. Played with us media Terrans. We TBT'd with him a whole lot. Quite naturally skilled back then. Nowadays, having great results in StarCraft 2, one of the strongest players on the team. In fact, I played him in StarCraft 2 a little bit as well.
Oh, we changed his name. His age to 25. All right.
Yeah, I didn't think he was 15.
I saw 15. I'm like, wow. Like,
I'm like, well,
I was like, because you did play with that guy a long time ago.
Yeah,
you played with
like,
him back when he was like 8. Yeah.
I suddenly don't feel so good for beating him, man.
Yeah, man. So, that's interesting. Well, let's find out who he's going to be playing against here in just a little bit.
Well, I've just been informed, Tasteless, by John, that they actually pre-announced the first two players.
Oh, did they? They didn't tell us, man. Didn't tell us that.
That's
well, let's see if our predictions are correct. I don't actually know who this player is. And Hack. All right.
Yeah, I remember this guy.
Picking out an unknown.
He played some GSTL before. A Terran player, if I recall correctly.
Yeah, Terran player.
Well, it's going to be a TBT. Moonen is pretty darn good at TBT. He was a StarCraft 1 Terran, so he's going to have some of that to back him up.
Well,
no, I don't know how much I like Moonen in first spot.
What?
I feel like he's one of the stronger players. I feel like I might just save him. Maybe second, third spot.
Well, you know, it's interesting. It's really a question of, do we actually put out the best guy first to try to wipe out as many of them? Or do we save him for last? So... You know what I mean? It's like
It's fair. I mean,
I think it just sort of depends on the teams you're up against and the lineups, and a lot of it is also how much stamina to do these. You know, does each player have?
Sometimes a player just has a match they want to do.
Yeah.
You know?
Or a matchup. Yeah.
Yeah. So
it's almost time, Artosis. Are you getting wiggly?
I'm getting jiggly.
The map is dual site. All the Han creeps were chased off the map. They said, "Who's coming down here?" GS, so they all started running, man.
All that remains is the Scantipede and the Goat.
Yes. The bravest.
Yeah, the bravest of the braves.
Yes. The countdown has started. The game is loading. Get ready for our foreign international team take on the Korean team here at the GSTL. And we're up over here in the left, representing the international scene.
FXO Moonen.
FXO Moonen.
Moonen.
Awesome. That is a great
sign
right there.
That guy is a poet. All right, over here in the upper right. Representing the Korean scene.
Genix, Hack.
I bet Hack doesn't have a great sign like that out there.
Go, Hack. Hope you break his back.
Ooh.
Yeah.
That's a terrible thing to hope, though,
Go, Hack. If you win this, I'm going to give you a little knick-knack.
Go, Hack. Put his head in a sack.
Yeah, that works. That's not bad.
I thought that was good. You look at me like, it's just okay.
Go hack your opponent. Don't know Jack, actually.
That's okay, too.
All right.
Go hack, give him a smack.
Oh, dude, why did we not think about that earlier? Yeah. We're so bad at this.
Go hack, make a Macarack.
All right, going for a refinery here is our Zenix player.
Moon in, no refinery yet. So
he
looks
might
like
go for quick command center.
Yeah. I mean, if you don't go for a refinery, you're either going to be proxying a barracks or you're going to go for the quick command. And ever since he doesn't even have an SCV out on the map, it tells us something, Tasteless. You know what that something is?
Tell me, Artosis.
He's going for the command center.
I knew that, but I'm going to act surprised.
And then we hear you write it down on a piece of paper.
All right, that was smart of Moonin to kind of ball that in early. Yeah, there's the little Baba guy.
Baba?
He's a Baba guy.
All right. So, wow. Voice crack already,
man. Whoa, puberty right there, guy.
I don't know what to say.
So.
My throat is a little tickly today anyway.
Is it?
I like sore, just a little bit tickly. I don't know. I think I need to drink a glass of water on the break.
I got a bottle of water next to me.
Could I have some?
Yeah.
Thanks.
Better not be sick, though, man. Get me sick.
Give you some cooties.
Don't want Artosis cooties. Moonin is actually making the command center here. Not at the expansion. He wants to land it there. I think that's smart because the opposing player, Hack, never actually scouted inside the base.
Yeah.
So he might be thinking, I hope there's no Banshees coming. That's he's getting a Reaper right now. So that's good. If you are scouted in this situation, you pretty much always want to make the command center on the low ground.
Mm. You know, I really actually like the Reaper build. I'm liking it more and more because the command center, it is later, just a little bit later, but that Reaper gives you some temporary map control. May or may not scout something. It can kill a Hellion somehow.
Yeah.
And it also gives you the opportunity, if you want, to get Stim very, very quickly, which in some cases, like against Banshee, is going to be amazing. So we're just going to have to see, will Hack actually get a quick Stim or not?
Now, there's a lot of different ways you can take a quick expand, quick command center. Mm. You know, we've seen some players, just mass barracks. We've seen people tech. In this case, we see a factory pretty quickly here. Oh, what are you doing, Reaper?
He's chilling.
Reaper had to tie his shoes. Doesn't want to trip over his Reaper shoes.
He stopped to look at that little rock in the ground next to flowers. Why is there
that's
a little
a pretty
piece of
rock.
Mineral? You know, that might be minerals in the ground. They need to excavate that.
Yeah, man. Now he's hiding an SCV behind the tree. That's smart. Reaper's in the bush.
You guys can't see him, but I promise he's there.
He's there. Bush Reapers. That's actually pretty smart, man. You really can't see the Reaper in the bush.
No? A Reaper in the bush is worth two in the hand.
Yeah, man. He did not actually see any of the structures up there with that scan.
Right now we have Stim going up for Moonin. So actually a quicker Stim for him while we do have Zenix Hack going up to Banshee Tech. His command center finishing up, dropping that mule and floating out. Now that's an interesting thing about the Reaper build as opposed to the one barracks command center build. You actually get to land your command center quicker.
Yeah.
You can't just kind of walk down your ramp with three Marines and be like, all right, I'm going to expand now. And look at that.
Bush
nice
Reaper.
Timing. Seeing a lot of what's going on.
Get that Bush Reaper!
He's no longer a Bush Reaper, Tasteless.
He's a dead Bush Reaper.
Yeah, he's a dead Reaper now.
Should have stayed in the bush, Bush Reaper.
Yeah, Bush was safe.
I thought he was actually going to park that there and wait for an SCV transfer at the expansion or something. But
yeah, that's what I was thinking as well. Well, we do have Cloak going up for Hack. In the meantime, Moonin is making a Viking and his Stim is over halfway done, so he should actually be totally fine against these Cloak Banshees. We'll have to see what type of micro.
Interesting, yeah, Medivac and a Viking.
And he also has a Missile Turret already, so Moonin is actually covering all his bases, Stasis.
Yeah, it's a very safe build he's doing here.
The bases are full. Can he hit the home run?
Dude, he dropped three mules at once. Looks like he was a little bit behind on his...
Looks like he was maybe saving it for a quick...
Oh, you know what he might have been doing? Banshee. He might have been saving three scans, yeah, for a Banshee. Yeah. You're very smart, Artosis.
Thank you.
Well... But Banshees are actually on the map now, still coming. Obviously, it's a little bit of a later Banshee rush.
But we do have a Viking in the path, Tasteless.
Dude, Moonin's right build is pretty solid.
Yeah, he knows what he's doing.
He's actually prepared for everything.
Moving moving out with some Marines. His stim is just about to finish as well. And look at that beautiful catch. Beautiful catch right there. And if he walks into turret range, that could be an issue right there. More hit points taken off. And that Banshee's basically done nothing. Does Moonin even know it's there? I don't think he does.
I think he actually
didn't realize that it happened.
He's attacking the goat. No, I'm kidding. He's not.
And he's actually in range of that turret. I'm not sure why he's actually sitting right there. It's kind of a dangerous locale.
Stim. Oh, that was a stim a little bit too soon.
The Banshee almost out of health. Does have 5 kills.
Nice.
Down it goes. Meantime, Moonin going around the map, gaining some map control.
I don't know if that Banshee actually did enough damage.
Yeah.
I don't know if you should go Banshees that late.
Well, it's a tricky thing. If your opponent doesn't prepare for it, then suddenly it's like, oh no, this is terrible. But Moonin is making plenty of missile turrets. He's got all the tech he needs to stop it. He's had that double command center for a while. In fact, wait a minute.
What?
Moonin only has 39 SCVs against 45 of
My god, he's just not macroing as well.
Yeah, Hack is actually non-stop
SCV. Moonin actually should have more SCVs.
Well, that's the point of getting such a quick command.
Uh-oh. Are you just going to not run with this Banshee? It's like pretty obvious what's going to happen here. All right.
Will
he
get the reactor?
No, he... Oh, that's pretty bad. Oh! Well, he almost disappeared in the fog for a minute. Did you see that?
No, because he almost disappeared. How would I see it? All right.
By not seeing it. All right. All right, here we go.
Whoa, Moonin getting a little hyper-aggressive here. There are a lot of Marines up there. It's got to be very careful.
A little scan there. But
we don't even have Stim started yet for... Wow, that's definitely a mistake. He's making a ton of Marines, but he hasn't started Stim.
You know, it looks like Moonin's actually just making a lot of mistakes that are hard to notice.
And we see the Banshee floating in. Going after that reactor again, perhaps? Nope. Siege tank for now. And Stim finally starts for half.
All right. Again with the reactor here. See if he actually gets it this time. 33 energy on that Banshee and scanned. And he did get the reactor. I don't know if the reactor is actually worth one Banshee, though.
Yeah, but he did have to use two scans on there as well.
You know, here's another thing. Is like, even if you kill the reactor and you really need a starported reactor, you can just swap it with another barracks.
That is quite true.
It's like, actually...
He hates reactors,
Oh, my God.
Totally hates them. Well, 3 scans and a reactor. I mean, that's pretty okay. Now...
I think this would... Well, go ahead.
There is a small problem, though. Hack has 59 SCVs against 42 of Moonin. So Moonin is just kind of behind on the macro. In fact, we're up 15 supply now for Hack. Just saying numbers. 15, 82, 22, 33.
Hike! Artosis is not our best cast so far, man. I don't know what it is, man. All right, we're rusty. We've been on vacation. All right, siege tanks, Marines, medevacs. For the most part, Hack's been sort of turtled in his base and using a little bit of Banshees for harassment. Moonin's been out and about. I think Moonin's more eager to actually have an engagement here.
And Hack moving up, taking a watchtower over. Using some scans, checking out where his opponent is. I wonder what the plan is here for Moonin.
I think a lot of this will depend on when Moonin takes his third base.
Looks like he might siege up on the low ground here.
There's no siege tanks here to defend, but at the same time, this isn't exactly a very big army.
He's going to have to scan again. He doesn't have anything to see the high ground.
Oh, my God. That was pretty bad by Moonin.
Yeah, that was quite a big mistake, losing a siege tank, doing nothing there, basically. And these Marines trying to catch that siege tank. Not going to happen, though. That was a little bit peculiar.
He must have just not had energy. He probably saw a moment where he was like, the guy's
on
the
map. Oh, no.
Oh, man, that's going to go down.
Yeah, and down it goes. Only a few Marines getting out. Easily cleaned up by Hack. And now Hack suddenly has a dominating lead. 160 supply to 120. Wow.
You know, despite Hack's harassment not that effective, you know, the truth of the matter is that Moonin has not damaged Hack at all.
Yeah.
So... That Moon does is, put him in the lead, yeah.
He's just kind of walking around the middle of the map. Hack's already taken a third. He's got more SCVs. He's got more units. He's just winning in basically every way.
And I can tell you one thing for sure. Hack is probably feeling so confident now that the medevac flew into his But yeah, oh, here we go.
Absolutely. And look at this.
Oh, nice snipe there. Hex, really good. Shut down that one tank and ran for it.
Right now, Hack does have 9 tanks against just 4 of Moonin, so Moonin's going to have a hard time.
He's going around Moonin's army.
Yeah, Moonin actually has no idea what's going on. He has no vision of that. And he is moving back now.
He's Moonin back.
He's moonwalking in back.
Oh! He needs to target fire those tanks to the front. Nope, backs up.
A lot of Marines going down there. And just more siege tanks.
Oh my god, he actually just killed everything.
Oops. Now he's up 70 supply.
We got a drop over here. But is this enough?
Yeah.
At this point in time, I think Hack actually might be able to just walk into the front door of Moonin's base.
Yeah, he may be able to. In fact, he is still pushing up. This is what happens when you just have a lot more siege
tanks. This is 103 supply to 73 supply.
And
173 supply, excuse me.
Beautiful drop and attack there. And Moonin is actually almost out of units up here. He's down at 81 supply.
Dude, this actually might be GG.
Yeah.
I mean, he's just going to get to the only expansion that Moonin has. And I got to say, Moonin, I know he's a good player. A little bit disappointing play this time for a sort of debut match here in the GS TL.
And we'll be able to take this all out. And that's going to be it, man.
That's it,
yeah.
Man.
Moonin is very, very dead. Just has nothing left. And I got to admit, I really like Moonin. Very good player, but he got completely and utterly outplayed in literally every single way this game.
Yeah, I mean,
there's no way in which he played better than Hack.
Yeah, there was Hack obviously was the person that deserved to win that.
Yeah.
GG.
And so Hack does remain, going up 1-0 for Zenix.
You see him walk out of there? That wasn't a door. That was a wall hack. All right. Well, Zenix has got to be feeling confident with a game like that.
I mean, their player just hacked Moonin apart, man.
Man. We right around the joke stand.
Be here all week. Yeah, it's Friday.
And you can see a little bit of tension here from the, you know,
now,
FXO team.
Who do you think, Casus, are they going to use on the next one?
Moonin is very disappointed in that. I would say, actually, for people in the background here, either QXC or Slog.
I would not use QXC. I would use someone specifically that's going to be strong against Terran. I think Slog's a good choice for that. I'm not saying QXC isn't strong against Terran, but you save him a little bit later.
Slog's got a lot of experience. This guy was pro gaming back when we were pro gaming.
He's always been very good PvP.
He doesn't actually get very nervous.
He used to a long time ago.
He used to.
But he played so many tournaments.
You do this enough, you know, you can't always be that nervous.
Usually, you get nervous with
younger players.
Quite true. So I think they need to use someone that is good against Terran, that they don't want to use against other people. A sniper, basically. You don't put in like a QXC that kind of beats everyone. You don't really, I don't think you put in a Sheth either. Why would you put Sheth in?
Well, here's my bet. If it's not Slog, then it'd probably be, the next two would be, I think, QXC and Sheth in that order.
I wouldn't use either of those. I would much more likely go with Slog. Or maybe Optic Zero.
No.
Optic Zero is actually
No, I'm talking about for the third and fourth player.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm just talking about the next player coming out.
No, I think Slog is a good bet,
I would definitely put out a Protoss. Either Slog or Optic Zero. I'm fine with both of them.
Yeah, well, I mean, they've already used one Terran. You know, they still have actually a good selection of races on FXO.
Oh, absolutely.
Now, Zenix is going to be very happy if the second player is taken out.
Oh, yeah. If you go up 2-0, man.
If they pull out a good Terran on FXO.
The thing is,
they could use Beyond. Beyond's Terran is really good.
Oh, that's very true.
You know, and if... Yeah, no, sorry. Please
go
ahead.
Not just that, but their ace player, basically, I guess you could say, Puzzle, their team captain, already took out Sheth, who is kind of the best player on FXO.
Yeah, not in this...
I mean, of course, they do have Oz, who's actually really, really good as well. In fact, he could be used here, but they might be saving for later. Oz is actually an insanely good StarCraft 1 pro who's actually very good at StarCraft 2 already.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. We'll see.
Who's it going to be? Suddenly, Wolf stands up, goes over there.
I don't think it's going to be Wolf.
We were right.
Slog. You know, it's a good choice. Throw Protoss out. I think that this is the way to do it, Tasteless. Get someone who is going to be good against Terran.
Slog's historically actually been very good at PvP.
That's been his best matchup.
And he's struggled a little bit with Protoss versus Zerg.
Yeah, he actually hates
we actually
DBC
it's
in this
so
game.
Funny that he is one of these guys that we actually competed.
Dude, I've actually
so trippy.
He lived in New York, and so in all the northeastern tournaments, he got second place in the places. Every single one, that poor guy.
I played against Slog in what tournament was it that I played against him?
The
Hollywood Invitational.
The U.S. Open.
The Open. Yeah.
He actually took my slot to go there.
Beat him PvP.
I had no money tasteless. I had to work at a retail store, so I gave the slot to Slog. Slot to Slog.
That's right. I would have been playing against you, man.
Yeah. Artosis rips Protoss nerd heads off and start that.
Hey, this would have taken all your ladder points, Artosis. I know you're hiding from me. He's almost choking on his teeth. All right, now. Slog, a guy who used to have some nerve issues, now very collected in matches. In fact, we talked to him briefly here in the studio. Totally, totally relaxed.
Yeah.
Going into this.
No, he feels good, man. He's put a lot of time in the game right now. I've played with him some on the U.S. server back when he was in USA, and I mods a lot of his games. He's a good player in this game, Faceless.
This guy, former professional poker player.
Yeah, until bill passed.
The United States actually destroyed the lives of poker players all over the place with that bill attached.
Yeah.
Or, like, froze all their accounts.
Gotta love it when that happens.
It's like, wow, well, like, you know what we're going to do? Let's wreck a bunch of lives. But actually, it's good that they did that because now Andy's playing StarCraft 2 again.
You are the worst.
Like, all these poker players at home, like.
Yeah, yeah.
That actually was a messed up law when it happened.
Yeah. It's.
What are they? The U.S. just like froze? Like, was that what it is? Froze every
all their
online
accounts,
poker
yeah.
account. A lot of people lost money on that. That's
what
sad.
What you gonna do, man?
What you gonna do?
Move somewhere else.
Move to Korea and be a pro gamer at the GSL.
There you go.
Yeah.
Well, the map is actually gonna be Tal'Darim Altar. Good map.
If Slog is in cross spots, that's going to be really good.
That or, if he's here, his opponent's here.
Oh, no, I'm just talking about the rotational symmetry.
There's because it's rotationally symmetric, there's actually, you can get better positions against each other.
Yep.
And the best one for a Protoss versus Terran would be with the Terran's natural, the back of it to your front.
All right, we're going to have a coach interview real fast, so enjoy.
It was quite good. It was better than I expected. I expected us to possibly get all killed, and we did very well. We studied as much as we possibly could. We looked at all their past GSTLs and decided what matchups we would put against who and who to expect to come out. I think we're pretty prepared for this. Shout out to my good friend Hotbed and DJ Wheat for making an amazing Team Liquid thread for us last week. Shout out to the Team Liquid community and our sponsors Razer and the various other sponsors that we have, which I cannot announce right now.
Last 경기를 보게 되었는데 그때는 조금 약간 부족한 감을 찾긴 했지만 이제 개인전을 보게 됐을 때 숀 시몬 선수가 대단히 잘하시는 모습을 보여줬기 때문에 이번에도 이제 그 선수를 이제 유의하면서 열심히 해야 될 거라 생각합니다. 네, 지난 3시즌 동안 이제 저희가 성적이 매우 안 좋았기 때문에 이번 시즌은 최소한 이제 먼저 첫 경기를 이제 잡고 가자는 마음으로 이제 모두 이제 힘을 합쳐서 이제 1승부터 하고 가자는 생각입니다. 네, FXO 팀을 이제 맞이하게 돼서 이제 저희가 이번엔 꼭 이길 거고 FXO 팀은 이제 2연패를 빠지게 되면서 한국 팀의 큰 벽을 느끼게 될 거라고 생각합니다.
We got some epic music for that GSL intro. Epic intro for the interview music. You know?
Jesus.
Yes, if I had to write lyrics for it, that's what I would do.
Interesting, they prepared well for Chef's matchup. They're afraid of Chef.
Well,
it's like Starship Troopers.
What?
They're afraid.
They're afraid. Of course the alien's afraid, man. What are you doing? You killed all his alien buddies, man.
I know. He's out all these guys pointing guns at him. He's just a brain alien. He can't actually
do
anything.
He's a brain alien, man. Of course he's going to be scared.
Of course.
He's smart. He's a brain alien.
Yeah. It's a brain bug. He's the infester, man.
Remember Krang?
Of course I remember
Krang.
He
was a brain alien, too. How many brain aliens are there? Now, think about that. No,
Krang was a special brain alien. I wonder if when
he
Krang
was from
picked
Dimension
things
X.
up, did he forget things? Because, like, he's
crushing
Well,
here's a question. He had
brain.
A mouth. Does Krang poop?
That's a good question.
That's a good question. See, I ask the hard questions.
He only has a few fangy teeth. Can he eat potato chips, or does it cut up his mouth? How does
I don't
that
know.
Work?
Does he brush? He's got those little... Does he have the... Does he... What is that thing? Is in the stomach? The android like brushes his teeth?
Brushes his four little teeth, man. Or something?
But there are questions that need a lot of brain aliens. Ah, you know why? That must be some kind of symbolism for human beings fearing intelligence.
Ooh, that's actually, you know what? I know you're right. All right, so we're going to be seeing Slog from FXO against our Xenix player,
Hax.
Took me a second to think of his name.
I would say Slog, I think, actually is the favorite in this.
Do you think so?
I don't know.
Man. Slog has not really proven himself in terms. In practice games, he's been very good.
But in StarCraft 1, he did, and that's basically like the same thing. You just like,
yeah.
I mean, StarCraft 2 is actually not that different from StarCraft 1. So, I mean, just to kind of switch over. So, yeah, I mean, I'd say that. All right, it's time. The countdown started. Our map is Tal Dirim Altar. It is Hack on the right. I got Slog on the left. Our American against our Korean. Well, I guess they're both ethnically Korean, but Slog is American.
That's okay. That's okay.
All right, head-to-head, let's do this. Game number two in the GSL Team League. Who's going to win? Let's find out. I'm Tasis. With me is Artosis. We're here in Seoul, Korea, and this is the GSTL.